There was high drama at South Mumbai's Campa Cola complex, where residents continued their protest even after the Supreme Court deadline to vacate illegal flats in the society ended today. Now, after residents refused to open the compound gates, blocking police entry into the complex, water, electricity and gas supply of vacant flats has been cut by BMC teams. Times Now's Ashish is reporting from the spot. Ashish, take us through the latest. Now, we believe that water, electricity as well as gas supplies have been cut, but the BMC did not go ahead with the demolition today.
Well, that's right. These are the initial steps to carry out any demolition process. The water, electricity and gas connections have been cut in the especially on the illegal floors that have been declared by Supreme Court over the buildings of Campa Cola compound. If my cameraman can show, the protest is still on. In fact, the residents of Campa Cola building are still blocking the main gate of the compound, and they are not allowing the BMC and other officers to enter inside this compound. But meanwhile, few teams of BMC and Mumbai police officers have managed to enter inside the Campa Cola compound, and they are basically marking the illegal floors and portions of this entire complex. This is the exact thing they are going to complete today, and as far as demolition is concerned, they will not be able to carry out the process today. As far as the assets are concerned, if my cameraman can show, the major assets of BMC, which will help them carry out the demolition process, are still waiting at the main road only. Bulldozers, BMC officers,
right.
Few equipments, which with the help of which they carry out the demolition process, are still being kept at the right outside the main
Absolutely.
Gate only. That's only because the residents of this society have
right
blocked
of,
the
Ashish,
main gate
of course, the BMC pretty intent on carrying out that demolition. They're talking about the fact that supply of electricity, gas as well as water has been cut. Now, here are some reactions we are getting on this.
Now, what we want is very simple. We all respect the judgment of the order of the Honorable Supreme Court, and every law-abiding citizen will abide by that order. There is no doubt about that. But at the same time, we met the Chief Minister last night. We also requested him, we told him that there are innocent little children staying in the building as of now. There are senior citizens residing in the building who have not yet left their homes. They have nowhere to go. State government should make adequate provision for them before pulling down these structures or taking any other action. Other than that, when we came here this morning, we requested the administration as well as the police force to kindly sit down with the residents, explain them the plan of action so that there is no confusion and the whole process can be carried out in a fair and peaceful manner. However, the police as well as the state administration have failed to explain anything to these residents, and therefore there was a chaos this morning.
There's no way of treating women. You're agitating at the gate and you have male constables pulling you like this and dragging you on the floor. This is not right. If this is a democracy, let us agitate. If you want to arrest us with women constables. Where were all the ladies constables? And you just treat women like this. You drag yourself on the road. I mean, it's just not on.
No, but exactly what provoked this this lathi charge there?
We were trying to defend them entering and bulldozing the gate, and all of us were standing there. But the point is, you can't have constables treat women like this, or for that matter, any citizen like this. I mean, you have to be sympathetic. We're all literate. You can request us to move out. You can't just drag us on the road and then hurt us.